My name is Stanislaw Liberto with AV Ultra, and today we're going to be taking a look at making lower thirds in After Effects. All right, so in our last example, we were taking a look at a basic static lower third. In this example, we're also going to be making a lower third, but you can tell that this is a little bit more going on here. So let's go ahead and start fresh here. Now, I'm just using this downtown Milwaukee as a placeholder. To be honest, we're going to make a lower third that we can put onto anything. And depending on what your outcome is, you may want to play onto that style. So for my particular example here, I'm going to be kind of playing this off as, you know, some sort of buildings or architectural type of show. So where I'm going to be throwing in some different buildings. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. I'm just going to start with a new comp right away. The reason why I'm starting with a new comp right away is so that way I have a clean slate to kind of look at and not be distracted by all the motion that's happening here. So I'm just going to call this lower third, buildings, and I'm making sure that it's set up the way I want it, 1920 by 1080, 10 seconds long, and I'll just hit OK. All right, so the very first thing I'm going to do is start designing it and kind of sketching it out the way I want. Now, in the past, we made our rectangle here, and that kind of drew it out like that. And the only thing we're going to do different this time, I want to soften those edges a little bit. So I'm actually going to pick the rounded rectangle tool, and that's up here. And when I click and I drag this out here, you can see what that's done here. It's kind of smoothed over these edges here. Now, if I go into my rectangle here, you can see under my path, I can actually change this roundness a little bit here, and that's just going to soften that out a little bit. For me, I'm happy with the way it was at 20 there, so I'm going to leave that as is. And I'm just going to call this one here Title Bar. All right. I also have a couple other assets I want to use in here. I've got some buildings that I've kind of cut out here and put together in Photoshop. That's what they look like here. Not the best, but a collection of different buildings that I found from Wikipedia. So they are licensed for reuse. Not stealing anybody's pictures here, not that I'm aware of. And I thought I'd throw in some blueprints here in the background there, so it kind of gives a little bit more architectural kind of feel to our title. So I'm also going to drag that guy right into our title bar here. All right. And right away, you can see that it's not necessarily going to fit, and that's okay, because I'm just going to scale this up. I'm holding on to Shift and scaling that up. And I'm kind of deciding where that's going to fit in my bar there. So I'm also going to hit W for my rotate here. And I'm just going to pull this to the side here. You can see that's rotated it. And I'm just taking a look at what's going to go there. All right. Now, the reason why I did this here is I'm going to take this title bar and I'm going to use the white from this title bar and kind of cut it out. So that way only that blueprint will show up in here. Now, what exactly am I talking about there? Well, I'm going to toggle my switches and modes here, and I'm going to make this a track mat. And so I'm going to take this to Luma Mat title bar. And what that's doing is it's using the white imagery in my shape layer and basically cutting it out like a stencil. So if I move my blueprint here, you can see what I'm doing there. And it's just moving it through that area as if it's a window. I'm going to turn my transparency so we can see what's going on here. You can see the outer edges of my blueprint page. And I'm just going to do something like that. Now, that's a little bright for me there. I want to darken up that blue a little bit. So I'm also going to go ahead and color correct that. And I'm going to throw on a curves adjustment here. And I'm just going to darken that up a little bit and add a little bit more blue. The only other thing I'm going to do here is blur it just a little bit because it might be a little hard to read any text on here, and I just kind of want to use it as a design piece. I'm just going to throw in a little bit of a fast blur and just blur that out. So you can tell that there's something happening there, but it could be anything. I just like to use that as a little bit of a style there. All right. And we'll make it so that way it's not so distracting, but you can tell that there's a little something happening there. Okay, very good. Excellent. Now I've got my title bar and I've got my blueprint in there. I also want to have a little bit of an outline around the outer edge here. So I'm going to take this title bar and I'm just going to duplicate it. And the reason why I've duplicated it, if I just turn that on here, you can see it's just solid there. Because I want it to be the same size and shape of my original title bar. And what I'm going to do with this second one, so I have my title bar, I'm going to call this title outline. And I'm going to turn off my fill, and I'm going to give it a stroke that's fairly white here. I never like to go to 100% white or 100% black because then I don't have any floor or ceiling that I can kind of push things. But I'm just going to give this like a maybe like a 5-point stroke. And if I click off there, you can kind of see what's happening there. I'm going to turn on my layer again. And you know what? Let's go ahead and let's make that just a little brighter. So I'll take that up just a little bit here. And that's starting to look pretty good. I'm also going to go ahead and I'm going to emboss the edges. And what this is going to do is just give it a little bit more depth. I'm going to drag that right onto my title outline. And you can see what that's done already. It's kind of taken these edges here and making it seem like it's a little thicker, like almost like it's a metal stroke around it. And I'm going to just make sure I'm in my title outline. And let's work with this a little bit. So I'm going to change this relief just a little bit here. And you can see what it's doing here. So I'm going to zoom in right on this edge here. And I'm going to turn this on and off so, just so we can see what's happening here. So if I turn this off, you can see it's just a solid bar. But with a bit of this relief on it, it's given this appearance like almost like it's a chrome and there's light wrapping around it here. So if I adjust this contrast here and this relief, I can kind of work with this a little bit. In fact, I can even change the direction of this emboss to kind of give it a little bit more of an interior shadow. Right, so I've got that, and I'm going to have this with that shadow upward here, and I'm also going to add a drop shadow in here. Now, the reason why I like to add a drop shadow is because it gives me, again, a little bit more depth, and I'm going to make this fairly large here and soften it out. And the reason for that is because now I can have a little bit more control over that depth. All right, so that's starting to look pretty good. If I want to turn off these extra lines here just so I can see what I've got going on, I can toggle my mask and shape path, and that makes things a little bit easier. And let's work with that color just a little bit more. I'll take that just a little brighter, and let's blend that with the original just a wee bit. All right, so that's starting to look pretty good. I'm going to take both my title and my title outline and my blueprint. I'm going to just select all of them and just scoot it up here a little bit. The reason for that is because I want to have some room for a subtitle. So I've got all three of these here. I'm going to leave them as is. In fact, I'm going to lock them just so I don't accidentally click on them and change them at all. And I'm going to create another shape here. And in this particular example here, some more rectangles. I'm going to create one across here, something fairly thin like that. And you'll notice that it's the same colors and options as the last ones I picked. So I'm just going to make this one a solid, let's say something close to this blue, and we'll make that just a little bit lighter so it stands out from it. And I'll hit OK. And I'm going to turn off the stroke for this one for right now. So we'll click on our stroke, and I can turn that off. A shortcut, by the way, is if you hold on to Alt Option, and I can actually click on the stroke box here, and it'll cycle through my different options. So that way I don't have to click on stroke and pick whichever one over here. I can just hold on to Alt Option and click on the color, and it's going to cycle through them. So right now I have it with no stroke. And there's my shape layer. I'm just going to call this side rectangle. I'm going to go ahead and change its anchor point to the center of that shape here. And we'll rotate it. And I'm just going to drag it down here. Just kind of see what that looks like. Notice I can change the size and shape of it still. And I'm going to drag this to the bottom here. So that way it's all kind of cut out there. All right, so we've got the one in fact. Let's make that just a little bit more blue so it stands out a little bit more. I've got one. I'm going to duplicate it by hitting Command-D, put another one right next to it, and then a third one right down here. So there we go. That's starting to look pretty good. And now I'm going to create my subtitle here. So I'm going to make a new shape, and this time let's use our pen tool. And I'm going to use my pen tool here, and I'm just going to draw out a little shape here. And once I have that drawn out, I can kind of finesse that a little bit more. I have my safe frames turned on here. That is using my title and action safe. That's clicked right here. So if you don't have that, that's what that is. And a lot of times I'll use this title action safe to lay out where my text is. If you'll notice when I have this turned on, this is a little bit of an aside, but it's pretty important. If I use this, I have these different kinds of grids showing up here. So we have a full 16 by 9s, and then we also have a 4/3 put right in there. And what this basically means is if you've ever worked with print before, we have crop lines and we also have bleed lines. Well, TVs kind of work something like that, where we have action safe and title safe. So this outer bar, if we want any of the action to be guaranteed to be seen on every TV that's out there, it needs to be within this frame here. And if we want anything to make sure that we read all the text, it typically needs to be in this frame here. While that's not always true for things online, because if we hit full screen, it's just going to adhere to those pixels. Some TVs have something called overscan and underscan, and that's why if you go to Best Buy or Target or wherever, you'll see the same image on every single screen, except some of them are a little bit larger, some of them are a little bit smaller. Little piece of trivia, use it as you wish. All right, so now I've got this subtitle bar here, and I've created that, so I'm just going to name it right away, subtitle bar. And I'm going to just change that color here. So we're going to make this fairly whitish. And I'm going to make sure it has no stroke. And I'm going to do the same thing I did with this other bar by giving it a second layer here, subtitle bar 2. And I'm going to call this subtitle outline. And I'm going to do that same thing. So I'm going to hold on to Alt Option, click my color to turn that off. And I'm going to turn this on. And we're going to make this just a little bit darker so it stands out from the white so we can see what's going on there. And I'll throw that drop shadow on that subtitle outline. We'll soften it so we can take a look at what's going on there. And I'm also going to grab that emboss again. Drag my emboss, put it right there. And we'll put our drop shadow after our emboss, so that way it shows up. If we have our drop shadow first, the emboss is going to work on that drop shadow. You can see what that's doing. It's getting rid of it. So the layer order that we have here is important. So I've taken my emboss here. Let's change this to so we can see this a little bit more. Click off of there really quick. And we'll take our emboss, work with that relief. All right. Okay, so that looks pretty good. So now I've got my subtitle bar. I also have my full title bar, and that subtitle bar is a little large for me. I think I'm going to drag that. Let's make them both. I'm going to select both of them here. Just make that a little bit smaller there. All right, the last thing I want to do is I want to add my little buildings in there. So I'm going to go to my project again, and I'm going to grab those buildings I've got here, and I'm just going to drag that right into my comp. So I'm going to plop that kind of where I'm going to want to see that, right over here, right? And I kind of want them cut in between those different layers. And so now I'm going to take my buildings, and I'm just going to shove them right down here. And if I want my buildings behind those rectangles, I can just drag them behind there. And now if I wanted to, I can kind of soften the edge of those bars there. But I kind of like the way that looks. Again, if I can take my rectangles here and I can reposition those, rotate them. And now I'm just going to add my text layers. So I'm just going to take my text and we're going to say title area. And I'm going to make sure it is on the top here. And let's change our sizes. And I'm just going to shove this to the side here, right inside my title safe. And I'm going to go ahead and again, duplicate it, make it a little smaller, drag it down here. And this is something really interesting. I did this on purpose here to kind of show you some different considerations. If I have some dark backgrounds here, I'm going to want to use some white text. And if I have some light backgrounds here, I'm probably going to want to change this to some dark text. It's just gonna make it easier to read because of the contrast. Typically, what I tend to do too, is I'll add a bit of drop shadow to my text layers. So that way it kind of pops from the background a little bit more. And I'm just gonna give that a little bit more distance and expand that. That's a little far. Maybe around 8. All right, so there we go. Now, if I take my downtown Milwaukee here, I can take that new comp, my lower thirds buildings here. This is our ones that we just completed. And I can drag that whole composition right into my timeline. I'll make sure that we just put it right up on top. And there we go. Now we have a stylized lower third. In our third part, we're going to take a look at animating this to build in. So we're going to have each of these pieces kind of fly in and kind of the color will change a little bit. Some of this blueprint will move here. These buildings will all pop up one at a time. And that's what we're going to take a look at next. What's great about this, though, is like I said, I can drop this into any piece of footage and it'll work. If I'm in Premiere, I can even take this whole After Effects file and drop in the After Effects file, and as long as I change out my text, it'll work. So again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Liberto with AV Ultra, and that is how you make a stylized lower third.